Hello and welcome to the channel. This system of simultaneous equations, some other videos attribute to Indian mathematical genius Srinivasa Ramanujan, who during his short life made a huge contribution into different areas of math and set up numerous mathematical problems. However, this problem looks too simple as compared to true Ramanujan's problems, some of which are presented here. As you can see, they aren't even remotely comparable with the one discussed here, so if you are really looking for a challenge, just pick one of these and quit the video. Hopefully someone is still watching, so let's continue. At start, we need to find the area of definition, the domain of x and y. Since the domain is not specified explicitly, we assume what is called natural domain, the values of x and y, where both expressions in the left-hand side are defined. Makes sense. We see that both x and y appear under square root sign, which applies only to non-negative values. Therefore, x and y are non-negative real numbers. The next step is solving the system, of course. The earlier mentioned video recommend subtracting the equations. So let's subtract the first equation from the second. The terms from the second equation appear with pluses, while the terms from the first equation appear with minuses. Then we factorize x minus y like that. The remaining terms are square root of y minus square root of x, which we need in a different order, so we place them with minus in front, and the right hand side is 4. Now square root of x minus square root of y is a common factor, and we complete factorization of the left hand side. So far so good. But what should we do next? The other videos insist on representing 4 as the product of two integers. However, this makes sense only if we are certain that the factors in the left-hand side are integers, while I don't see any evidence for that. And according to the comments, I am not the only one having such a confusion. So let's wipe that out and look for a different approach. The first equation of the system can be rewritten as y equals 7 minus square root of x. According to the definition of arithmetic square root, as this is what the square root sign means, square root of x is non-negative. Therefore, y does not exceed 7. Then square root of y doesn't exceed square root of 7, which in turn is less than 3, as 3 squared is 9. Let's write that in a neater way. Square root of y is non-negative, again according to the definition of the arithmetic square root, and less than 3. Now let's rewrite the second equation of the system, x equals 11 minus square root of y, and apply to it the inequality for the square root of y. We multiply the inequality by negative 1, so the inequality signs are changed to the opposite. Then we add 11 and get the expression for x in the middle. Therefore, x is more than 8 and no more than 11. Now we write the inequality for square root of x and extend it, observing that square root of 8 is greater than 2, whereas square root of 11 is less than 4. Thus we get square root of x is more than 2 and less than 4, and we need to substitute this inequality back into the expression for y. So we multiply the inequality for square root of x by negative 1, then add 7. This gives the expression for y in the middle of inequality. So we found that y is more than 3 and less than 5. The only integer satisfying the inequality for y is 4, which happens to be a full square. So let's try y equals 4. Maybe it will work. Substitute 4 for y into the given system of simultaneous equations and simplify and obtain consistent equations. If x equals 9, then indeed square root of x equals 3. This means that one solution is found. X equals 9, y equals 4. And we are looking for other solutions. To do that, I used graphs. The first equation gives y equals 7 minus square root of x. The graph of square root is half of the parabola, pointing rightward and located not below x-axis. However, in the formula, square root appears with negative sign. Therefore, we need to reflect the graph about x-axis to get the graph of negative square root. Finally, we move the obtained graph 7 points upward and get the graph corresponding to the first equation of the system. The second equation of the system gives square root of y equals 11 minus x. And taking a square, we get y equals 11 minus x squared, which can be also written as y equals x minus 11 squared. The graph of this function, according to textbook, is a parabola y equals x squared, shifted 11 points rightward. And we see that the graphs have two common points, so it looks like the given system of simultaneous equations has two solutions. However, if we consider another equation, square root of y equals x minus 11, and take the square of it, we get exactly the same equation as before. This means that the blue graph is actually a union of two graphs, corresponding to equation A and equation B. So we need to filter out the irrelevant points, corresponding to equation B but not to equation A. We see that the left-hand side of both equations is a non-negative number. Therefore, the right-hand sides must be non-negative as well. For equation A, we get 11 minus x is greater or equal to 0, therefore x is less or equal to 11, while the equation B gives x minus 11 is greater or equal to 0. So, in this case, x is greater or equal to 11. This means that the points of blue graph with x greater than 11 correspond only to equation B and therefore need to be dropped. So, we are left only with the left, sorry for the pun, branch of the graph, representing the second equation of the system. Now, the two graphs have only one common point, which means that the given system of equations has a single solution. And we know this solution. And we know even more. No other pair of even fraction of x and y satisfies this system of simultaneous equations. And this is, guess what? The end! Wow, slightly over 8 minutes. I wonder how long will take solving a true Ramanujan's problem.